Hey guys, it's Katie and today's video is going to be what's in my iPhone updated version. I did one a couple of months ago, but I've recently changed around my iPhone organization and made it a little more aesthetic. If you guys saw my iPhone customization video, you'd kind of know what I did, but I want to show you a full view of what I actually did. Also, if you haven't seen that video, make sure you go check it out after this one and let's get right into the video. I feel like I said video 5 times in a row, but that's okay. Scoot over a little bit. Hopefully I'm still in frame. Okay, we'll see. So I'm gonna put my screen up on here as usual and we're just gonna go through it. Okay, starting out with my home screen, we have a picture of me and my boyfriend in Chicago, and what I did in my iPhone customization video was I animated it, and if you hold it down it animates so you can see me moving, he's moving, and it's just really cute and it's so much fun to play with. So if you guys want to know how to do that, definitely check out that video. For my background, I have this photo from Pinterest. It's just a really pretty mountain photo and I absolutely love it, and it's just so aesthetic and happy. Then over here, we're gonna go to my widgets page. So I have three different things on my widgets page. I have my favorites, so people I need to call immediately. Then I have a calendar, which I have no events today, which is kind of sad, but yeah, I don't have any events today. And then I have batteries, which is really interesting. Obviously, on my iPhone, I know how much battery percentage I have, but I don't have to look at my watch every time I wanna know what battery percentage it's at. So if I'm not wearing it, like I'm not right now, I can tell that it's at 40%, and next time that I wanna go out, I should probably charge it. Now we're gonna go into my apps, and we have books, calculator, notes I use religiously for basically anything. I'll do songwriting here, I'll do captions for Instagram posts, hashtags, just a bunch of stuff here. Then I have Snapchat, and hello. I just kinda use Snapchat casually. We have Find My Friends, where I track my friends if I need to know where they are. FaceTime, Weather, App Store. Then we have Instagram. Just gonna pull my Instagram. If you guys aren't following me on Instagram, it's infinitebeauty7. Definitely follow me. I try to post as much as I can, and I'm starting to get into a little more consistent feed. And I'm gonna show you guys quickly how I edit my photos also. But yeah, there's Instagram. We have photos. I think I have more photos than I did last time, so that's an oops. I'm just really lazy and I don't really want to delete them, but I probably should. So I have 1,700 plus, almost 800. We have maps, camera, then I have my finance folder. For every folder, I made all the titles lowercase and spaced out. I think it looks so aesthetic and pleasing and just so pretty, so that's why I did that. We have Venmo, and then Fifth Third, which is just my bank. I don't know if I should have said that, but it's okay. Then we have social, and I have a Twitter. I don't really know how to use Twitter. I just kind of read other people's tweets, but I have a Twitter for my Instagram and YouTube. It's 7InfiniteBeauty if you guys want to follow me. I just post like random crap on there. I have a Pinterest. This, you should follow me. I just love looking for inspiration on housing, on clothes, just literally anything. So my profile is infinitebeauty7. You should definitely hit me up with a follow on that. Then we have Curtsy, which is a reselling app. I don't really use it that much. We have Messenger for Facebook, Uber, Facebook, Slack, and GroupMe. Those are both things that I use for organizations at school, so that's why I have those. Then we have Ticketmaster. Obviously, I'm not gonna be going to any events, unfortunately, so I don't really need to use that right now. Milkshake is a great place if you want to link a bunch of links under one link. So this is what a lot of people use for their Instagram. So as you can see, you can link your last YouTube video, you can link your blog, your Pinterest, a bunch of different links under one, which I think is super cool. Starbucks, House Party. I don't use House Party, but I have it. Depop, Mercari, and Poshmark are three reselling apps. So these are the apps that I use to sell my clothes if I don't want them anymore. Romwe and Shein, I know those are both companies that are kind of sketchy, so I don't really buy from them anymore at all, but I just have the apps. And then I have Twitch because my boyfriend's a gamer and I just have it. Next we're going into Photo. These are my main photo editing apps that I use, so Visco, Lightroom, and Fonto. Visco is what I use for just like basic photo editing. This is my personal profile, but I also have an Infinite Beauty 7 profile that you guys can go check out. Then I use Lightroom for more in-detail editing and also for my presets. So I have created a couple of presets that I personally use. I don't think I'm gonna sell them in the future, but let me know if you'd be interested in that. So if you can see this photo, for example, if you hold it down, you can see what the original looked like. And I just think it's very light and airy, and it's kind of got this blue tone to it that I really like. And I think that this app has really helped me with a consistent theme, which is a good thing. Then we have Fonto. Fonto is a great app for for adding text to your photos. So let's take this photo, for example. Actually, we're not gonna use this one. Let's take this photo, and all you have to do is hit add text. This is what I use for my text for thumbnails. I'll show you what I use for my thumbnail editing though. So we're just gonna type something fun. Okay, we're gonna type help. And then you can change the coloring, you could change the outline, so it's just a really great app to use for text, and it's really fun to use. We have Preview, which shows you kind of like a preview of what your feed would look like. You can just organize your photos. That's really helpful. Shutterfly is where I order all of my photo prints. If you have the app, they have a deal where all you have to do is pay for shipping, and it does save you money in the long run. Sprocket is the app that I use to connect to my mini photo printer, which I absolutely love. It's so cute. Facetune and PicsArt I actually don't use that much, but I mean, they're good. Afterlight is an app that I also don't use that much. Then we have Made, which is kind of like a Instagram story template, along with Unfold, which is also a story template. And then we have WeHeartIt, which I haven't opened in years, so I kind of want to go on that again. But we also have WordSwag and then Film, which are more photo editing apps. Hoopla is actually not photos, but it's kind of like a personal library on your phone. So I have it hooked up to my local library, which is really cool. Google Photos is where I save all my storage. I have it hooked up to my phone, so it will automatically sync all of my photos onto Google Photos so I don't lose them. And then the 24 FPS, I'm not really sure what that is. I think it's like another photo editing app, maybe. Yes, oh, that's my foot. That's so awkward, I'm sorry. And then YouTube Tracker is just kind of tracking, just like my YouTube analytics and stuff like that. Yeah, I'm not very good at explaining stuff, sorry. Next we have music, and I have music, Spotify, podcasts, iTunes Store, and voice memos. I use podcasts sometimes. I usually listen to music mostly, but I've been listening to Jasmine Starr, and she's just really good and inspirational. And then in terms of voice memos, I also use voice memos a lot for songs and voiceovers. Swiping over to the next page, we have games. I don't play a lot of games on my phone anymore. I have Starlit Adventures, Toy Blast, Block Hexa, Temple Run, Slices, Best Fiends. Best Fiends was an app that a lot of YouTubers were like promoted to tell people about, and I just like never was into it, but recently I have been into it, so there's that. Then we have Sorted 3D and Block Puzzle, Blackjack. So as you can see, I just have a bunch of games that I used to play a lot, but now I don't. Moving on to video, I have YouTube, YouTube Studio. If you are a YouTuber, YouTube Studio will be your best friend. It's just a super easy way to look at your analytics, look at your most recent videos, and respond to comments. I absolutely love it. iMovie Hype Type is like a photo text typer thing on your phone. For videos, Vont is kind of like Fonto, which is the text for photos, but Vont is the text for videos. And then we have Clips. Mojo, I think, is another Instagram story editing thing. Netflix, IGTV, TikTok, of course, and then Apple TV. Then we have School, and I have offloaded a bunch of these apps just because I don't use them anymore, and if you guys want to see how to offload them, I have a couple videos that I'll link down showing you guys how to offload them. It's just in settings. But I have Trello, which is my content planner. If you guys want to see how I plan out my content and a content planner that I use that is absolutely amazing, let me know and I will do that video. I'm also getting like... Okay. We're good. Quizlet is an app that I use for school when I'm trying to study. It's a really great app for flashcards. Coursical is a great app for scheduling your classes for college. Duo Mobile is something Miami University makes you have. My Vote is something for my sorority. WhatsApp is just like the international texting app. Mobile ID is something also from Miami. Google Docs, you guys probably know what that is. Omega Phi is for my sorority, Oxford to you, SurveyMonkey. So this is just basically all the boring school stuff that I need on my phone. Now moving into health, I have two health apps, the typical health app that they have, and then Workout for Women. This is a great workout app that I use with my friends, and I just think it's really good, and they have a ton of different workouts that you guys can do, and some of them are decently easy, and some of them are harder and will make you sweat. Watch, since I have an Apple Watch, I have my little watch category things. I never hit my activity rings because at home I'm just lazy, but there's that. This folder is called Tools. I used to call it Stuff. I feel like Tools sounds a little more fancy. I don't know if that's reasonable, but it happens. So I have Pages, Numbers, Keynote, GarageBand, iTunes, U, Bus Tracker, Drive, Dropbox, and Measure. As you can see, most of these apps are offloaded because I don't use them. And then we have Shortcuts, Apple Store, Files, Wallet. Wallet is where I use to put my concert tickets. I could not think of the word. Concert tickets. And then I have a couple barcodes that I need to keep on hand for my organizations. Stocks, News, Compass, and then Tips. Then we have Settings and Clock. You guys should be so proud of me. I went through and I deleted a lot of my alarms. If you guys remember, I had 50 million alarms. I still have a lot now, but not as many as I used to. So I just have all my alarms, and then my world clock, I made it down to 3 instead of like 7 or 8 world clocks because I don't really need those. Whew, getting out of breath. We're almost on them. So we have contacts, then calendar. As you can see, my calendar is always full of just random stuff, except for today. Today I have nothing going on. Then we have reminders. Reminders is great for everyday or daily tasks that need to be done. So as you can see, the first one, just ignore that one. But the second one and the third one and the fourth one, these are things that I need to do either weekly or daily. And it just alerts me at a specific time every single day, and it really helps me keep track of what I need to be doing. Canva is the app that I use to create my thumbnails, to create my graphics, to create my green screens. I actually do this on my computer, so it's a really great website, and I don't really like the app. It's kind of hard to do, but if I ever need to design something really quickly, I will use the app. So as you can see, I have a ton of designs already there. And then Pokemon Go. I know this app was like 5 years ago and it was popular then, and it's probably not popular now, but my boyfriend got me addicted to it. It is so much fun, and the little Pokemon are so cute, and I got my sister addicted to it. Okay, so my camera rudely cut me off, but we are almost done, I promise. So on the bottom bar, we have my phone, mail, and then my messages, and then we also have Safari. So we're gonna take a quick peek at what I have. I have the Chandler Dance sticker, the Adventure Challenge, which the page is not found, and then we have this angry octopus plush. I saw this on TikTok. It is the cutest thing ever, and I absolutely love it and really want one. And then we have a man and woman silhouette because I've been really into painting and I wanted to draw something like that. So that is it. Okay, so that is it for What's on My iPhone Updated, and I am so happy I got to share with you guys some of my favorite apps. If you want to know how I customize my iPhone, if you want some ideas, I don't know why I can't speak anymore. If you want some ideas, definitely go check out my iPhone customization video because I have a lot of fun things there, and I made my phone so aesthetic and I absolutely love it. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this longer video. I hope you guys have a great day, and I'll see you later. Bye!